After you, the white button on top.
That's dope.
You like it?
Yeah, that's insane.
This video is sponsored by Micro Center, who has actually supplied all of the computer parts for this video, which honestly is a bit of a miracle. Building a computer nowadays is hard. It costs you an arm and a leg to get the parts, if you can even find them. Fortunately, with stores like Micro Center, that is not the case. Somehow, throughout this computer part drought, Micro Center has found a way to not only have parts in stock, but also keep them available at fair prices. I'm not kidding when I say that this project would literally be impossible without their help. If you are looking to build a computer for yourself, especially at a good deal and a fair price, you really should check out Micro Center. Find out what stores are near you, and they also have a really cool promotion going on right now. So if you click the link in the description, they're actually even offering you free stuff. It does not get better than that. Please be sure to check out Micro Center. They are a godsend. Anyways, thank you so much to Micro Center for sponsoring the video. Now, let's get back to the rest of it.
We are building the most beautiful and custom PC for the best streamer of the year. Who is that, you might ask?
Boys, the plan, it's simple, I'm saying.
Now, if you don't know who Ludwig is, you kind of live under a rock. He is one of the most popular and hardest working content creators today. Not to take the spotlight away from other great content creators in 2021, but here's why he's the best. For 2 years, Ludwig has uploaded a video to his YouTube channel every single day, constantly growing his audience and entertaining millions of people. He is as consistent can be. Now you might think, oh, he must have just been spamming mediocre content every single day just to get something uploaded. But no, he hosted multiple $1,000 tournaments in multiple different categories. He had a kickball tournament where he invited the biggest streamers out for a one-day competition. He has hosted the largest Smash Brothers tournament in the history of Twitch, along with a bunch of other fighting game tournaments. He's hosted multiple game shows inviting out the biggest personalities in content creation.
I came all the way from here from Canada to do this stupid show, and this is culturally insensitive. There's no way I could know any of this. It's American bullshit.
It's crazy. There's so many people in this room and nobody asked. That's the craziest thing about it.
Last year, he even recorded his own Christmas album, and of course, he is the streamer with the most successful subathon, making him the number one most subscribed channel in Twitch history. On top of that, the content in between those major events is also really entertaining as well. So if you haven't checked him out yet, you really should. Now, why am I building him a PC? I really look up to Ludwig. The reason I wanted to build him something special is because of how much he inspires me right now. But first, you need to understand why I look up to him so much. You see, 2 years ago, my dad died of cancer. While he was going through all of the pain and the treatments, I used to be super motivated to make content and put out videos because I wanted my dad to see that I was going to be okay. I really believed that if I hit bigger numbers and new milestones, that the last best gift that I could give to my dad is him knowing that he raised a successful son. And then when he did die, that motivation to hit those numbers and milestones almost completely died. So for almost 2 years, I have kind of just been coasting off of my previous success on YouTube and Twitch, not really caring. Then fast forward to the rise of Ludwig, and all of a sudden I start hearing about this charismatic white dude who is constantly screaming,
"We just hit a million, but it'd be cool to have a bigger number, because the bigger the number, the better the person I am. That's a fact, that's how it works."
And at the time that I heard that, I instinctively thought, what a dumbass. I was super jaded from what had happened in my life, and hearing someone who cared about numbers so much like that, I just thought that he was an idiot and he didn't know better. But either way, I was curious, so I gave his content a try, and after watching it enough, what I saw wasn't actually a person who cared that much about numbers, but instead was a very positive, hardworking, and inclusive guy. And so now you know why I want to build him a computer. Now we need to find out if he even wants one.
So
this conversation determines quite a bit here today, obviously, because I need to ask you some questions. Number one, do you want a computer?
Yeah, I'm down for a computer.
Okay, perfect. I'll tell you this right off the get-go. Do you want to know the artist we got, or do you want to be surprised?
Surprise me. It's better content if you surprise me.
So, this PC is going to be built inside a Fractal Design Meshify 2 case, which has a lot of empty spaces on the outside as well as the inside. Normally, people don't do anything with those empty spaces, but we are going to cover them in some completely unique art. Can I turn these into NFTs? Will, can I make money on this? Okay. So let's go over the overall concept. In case you don't already know, Ludwig is kind of in his own world. Part of his story on Twitch is that he was one of the few people, if not the only person, who was around 10,000 live viewers with almost no viewership overlap. He was a very popular content creator, but what's rare on Twitch is for people to be popular and for others to have not heard about them. So for the art design, I want to make this him in his own world. Ludwig does a lot of variety content, and so I think there is definitely enough within what he does to create his own little universe. So with that out of the way, this theme is going to be somewhat outer spacey, but he's going to have his own planet. And so one thing that I want to do for the back panel, which is going to be the most unique art piece, is I want it to be this giant planet, and we're kind of looking at it from the atmosphere. That's our POV. And number one thing I need to have first is we're going to have Ludwig riding in his carpet. So we're going to kind of have him just kind of flying through the universe on this bed. Now, I'm going to litter this thing with references to him, and I'll try to kind of cover them as I go through it. Number one, his first emote on Twitch. I think it's a cute gesture. Instead of having the car with, you know, whatever kind of logo it would have at the front, we're going to make it a brown star. Why is it a brown star? Because he is 5 years old and makes the jokes like one. So while we're going to have him sitting inside this car bed, we're going to have, I want to say, Jigglypuff riding somewhere inside of this car bed, because Jigglypuff is his main in Melee, and Melee is one of the biggest Smash games that he, I want to say, what's one of the biggest, but anyways, it's his main game. It's kind of where he started. His origin stories on the internet, I would say, are in Super Smash Brothers Melee, and that's why we're going to make a reference to it, kind of showing his origin points. Inside the car bed, I think we have, like, I don't know, his Christmas album just like kind of chilling in here somewhere. I know he does like a lot of Super Mario Brothers like speedrun type things. So I think we'll have Mario kind of running from Bowser, maybe up here in the top left. Oh, wait, he's a Nintendo fan, obviously, if that much isn't clear. Let's put Rainbow Road back here. Off the car bed. We're gonna add some Smash characters down here, I think, to represent some of his other friends that are important to him in his friend group, represented by, I want to say, Falco, Fox, and Captain Falcon. I think each of those will represent an important person in his life. One thing is for sure, I want to have a million of these little like GPS pings all across the map, because another big interest of his is GeoGuessr. Ludwig has played so much GeoGuessr on stream, but it's also something that he finds interesting, and he's made content on it on his YouTube channel as well as his live streams. So I think it'll be a cute little reference. There was also that period of Rust on Twitch that was really, really, really popular. So I think if we can have some of the little characters in this like J10 segment of the Rust map kind of looking like little beans, like little Among Us beans. There we go. We can have like a 2-for-1 reference. Among Us as well as Rust. We'll mix it into one. We'll have it like down here. I know he has pets. I know, unfortunately, his dog did pass away recently, and he has a cat named Durs. So I think something that might be cute is if we have his dog, Sophie, running underneath and having Durs the cat just kind of like, oh my God, this drawing is so bad. Please don't judge me. But we have Durs the cat riding on Sophie over here on the left. Oh, another thing. Obviously, he did have the largest Smash Brothers tournament ever. It was called the, I think, LACS, the Ludwig Agren Challenger Series. What we're going to do is we're going to have a little coliseum to represent that fighting tournament. There was also that time he bought Shroud for $50,000 for charity. We'll put Shroud with like a little $50,000 price tag. Perfect. Just like a YouTube thumbnail. He'll appreciate that. And then, you know, we'll have like some like outer space planets like kind of going on up here, and maybe like a little city, skyscrapers, something off in the distance. All right. I think this is good for the back panel. Next, obviously, there's going to be a top and a front panel. And I think I just want to keep the top panel just outer space. There's going to be stars and shit. Nothing too creative. There is another thing I do want to do for the front panel, though. Now, another part of Ludwig's history is his masochistic desires to play incredibly difficult platform games. We're talking Jump King, Pogo Stuck, and Getting Over It. So something I want to do is I want to dedicate a panel specifically to those videos. I imagine a grass field here. We'll have the Jump King guy down here posing off epically, looking up to the sky. And then we'll have Pogo Stuck dude just kind of flying through the sky, sitting here on his little pogo stick. And then I think we also have the Getting Over It guy, little cauldron, just flying with his little hammer off into the sky. And then we'll just have a bunch of stars, planets, something like that. Very simple design. I think it'll be kind of funny. Next, graphics card. So I want to do is I want to put Ludwig's friendships on a chessboard. The reason I want to put it on a chessboard is because one of the biggest events that happened for Ludwig was an event called PogChamps. It was a chess tournament, and a lot of the reason it was so successful and big for him is because it was, honestly, I think the first time he ever had very meaningful collabs outside of his existing friend group. And so that was kind of like the reveal to, hey, I'm Ludwig. Hi, how are you? So what I want to do is I want to turn a lot of these chess pieces into his friendships. They're just going to be chess pieces. None of them are meant to actually be, you know, of importance. I will do this though. A joke that was something in his community was that his girlfriend, Cutie Cinderella, is taller than him. So one thing I want to do, which is also how it works in chess, is I want to have the queen, Cutie, to be taller than the king. I think it'll be a funny little reference. Now, this one is a little bit different from what I normally do, but there's actually a huge inner panel that is just left empty inside this case, which doesn't really happen in a lot of other PC cases. So what I want to do for this is I want to put Ludwig as Professor Oak. So like, I don't know, have him like wearing the coattail jacket or whatever, and have him opening up Pokemon cards. The reason I want to do that is because there was a huge collaboration on Ludwig's stream where he had a bunch of other streamers chip in like $1,000, $2,000, a couple thousand dollars to open a $30,000 box of Pokemon cards. Why would you pay that much for that? So we just have him as Professor Oak. I know it looks beautiful opening up these cards and it just shining and glowing as this $30,000 box just gets desecrated. Last and final piece, we're going to have the power supply shroud, which is a huge center focal piece at the bottom of the case. We're going to have it be something simple, but on brand. So Ludwig's, I don't know if it's the name of his company, but it's just his brand. It's Mogul Moves. So something that I think would be a nice, cute little reference, but also goes along perfectly with the outer space theme is having a little rocket fly across the space in the background of the Mogul Moves logo blasting off through space. The reason I think this is a really cute reference is because during his subathon, there was a little rocket that indicated the uptime of the stream. The more you donated, the more the rocket went up. And if the rocket was up, it meant the subathon continued. So I think it'll be a nice little reference to that as well as just fitting along with the theme of, you know, outer space. Now, obviously I can't draw worth shit. But fortunately, I know somebody who does. An artist named Savanto has been popping up in my Twitter timeline because of his insanely popular and well-drawn comfy cartel comics based off of Offline TV and Friends. As soon as I saw this style, as well as how good he was, I just had to get him involved. Okay, so I talked to Cutie and she gave a lot of insight on what we should do, what we should have included. So there's a concept for everything now. So we have an idea for everything. This is the skinny front power supply cover on top. This is the graphics card. We already have the back cover. We have the front and top panels because it's just going to be basically the outer space with planets on it. The one giant SSD cover thing we have is him as Professor Oak opening cards.
I think everything's settled then.
Yeah, those are all the concepts.
I'll do some sort of testing in a way. Let me just...
See, it's
kind of an example. Ooh, RGB now.
Exactly. That's basically how it works, dude.
So, this top priority first.
Yes.
Chances are this is also the second, third, fourth, and last. This.
Yeah. Good luck, Sev. If you need anything from me, let me know. Whether it's me praying, yelling, screaming, or crying.
Yes, please. Anything.
Okay.
All of it.
Okay. He's so f***ed. After what felt like 1,000 edits to the art, it was finally done. Now that we have the art, we get to put it on the case. But unfortunately, I don't have fancy materials or printers that can get all of this art onto the case. But my friends at V1 Tech do. So we're gonna be sending the designs off to them so they can actually print the art onto the case as well as onto acrylic RGB plates. Without them, this project is literally impossible. Once you see the stuff they're able to do, you're going to want some of it for yourself. And good news, they have a sale going on right now for 50% off. So if you like what you see in terms of what the computer is gonna look like, please be sure to check out their website. The link's in the description. Get something for yourself and or for a friend. Holiday season's coming up. Now that the PC is finally done, the only thing left to do is a 4-hour drive to LA.
How you doing?
Doing well.
Nice to meet you.
Buddy. Nice to meet you too.
You just want to bring that in and I'll look away.
It's boxed up, so you can take a look at the box, but
all right,
yeah, let's do that.
You want a hand?
What the hell are these?
These? The drip? You noticed? These are limited edition Croc Lightning McQueen for adults. They're a size up. They didn't have size 11. I had to get them on eBay. You know?
No, it's all good. I got a personal agenda with anything cars related.
What is it? Against it? You have an agenda against Cars, the Pixar animated film.
This is my most watched clip, unfortunately.
The Cars?
Yeah.
Cars 3?
Yep.
I mean, better than Cars 2, I suppose.
All right.
What's over here?
Where the magic happens, yeah?
Hey, yeah, this is it. This is the studio.
Okay, let me take this off over here, okay?
Oh, you can keep them on.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm not upset. Or you can throw some Crocs if you want. I got extras.
You know, I'll... I will flip it over.
Okay.
Imagine it broke right now.
That would be terrible, but pretty good clip.
All right, so... I guess we'll start with the back and we'll work our way through the rest of it.
Okay. All right, I'm gonna sit crisscross applesauce like a child, get close to it.
So, this is the build.
What the fuck? That's crazy.
So, got a couple of pieces here on the inside.
Is that
inside.
Me?
Yep.
I'm so fucking hot. Bro, is that what you think I look like? I got like 17 extra jaw space. That's amazing.
So we got a couple of things in here. The art pieces aren't even doing what they're supposed to do yet.
Okay.
So we thought this one would work best for everything that's going
to
be going on.
They're supposed to do something.
Yeah.
Right, because that's what art is. It's supposed to do something.
For the graphics card backplate.
Uh-huh. It's better. Beautiful. Is that a chessboard?
Yeah.
That's me and Cutie?
Yep. So there,
Mango?
There are a couple people on there.
He's so cute. You made him so a little cute Mango.
In here, we got a couple of things. Number one, one of the biggest memes that I heard from your community and from some of your mods is that Cutie is taller than you. And that obviously chess is important to you.
Chris, you know that's a lie. It's a farce. This is...
We have Stans and A-Truck over here.
The bishops.
We have Mango over here. We have Hess back here. We have your mom and your sister all the way here in the back.
Wow.
We have Christian, Ben, Nick, and Slime over here on the right.
God, you got my biffles.
Yeah, we tried to get the people that were most important to you.
I mean, it's right. It's accurate.
Over here on the right is a more specific reference. So okay. If you look at the cards back here.
Ooh, Dark Raichu in the Flareon.
Blastoise up here.
Nice. Harder to see. From the legendary box break.
Exactly. Yeah. So I started to notice after going through some more of your content that Nintendo, and now it's more apparent than being in here, Nintendo's a pretty big deal to you.
I have the same exact box that I broke. I bought two of them because I wanted one to just hold on to forever that I never opened.
Oh my God.
So I have that still. And then here's the Blastoise I have. I mean, it's the game, but jeez. Yeah, I like Nintendo. That's pretty true. That's a good call, Chris.
But yeah, we have you here opening up the packs. We try to get some of the cards out here to pay reference to that video, because I remember even before I started watching a lot more of your content, that was one of the things that popped up in my inbox, and I was just like, how do you spend $30,000 on Pokemon cards?
Yeah, it was the first time I ever hit 100,000 views live. Was opening that for Pokemon Week, which blew my mind. I was like, I'll never do this again.
So, here's the front panel. It's a little harder to see because this was printed on mesh.
I know. I know everything here.
Okay.
This is, all these three things have ruined me individually, my life and my mental health.
Not too complicated, but I thought it was a nice little front piece.
No, I love that. It's beautiful.
And then if we swap it over to the back.
Ooh. I saw this. This is what you posted on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
A part of it, at least.
What I try to do for the back piece is try to make it the most epic art piece, because it's going to be the biggest one. It's sad because it's on the back, but it covers a large part of the computer, so I figure put a lot of effort into it. There are a lot of different references in here, so I guess we'll just start with the middle.
Yeah.
Obviously, we have you in the car bed.
Yeah, classic, which I don't know if you saw on the way over, was in pieces. but yeah, I do love that bed. Mm-hmm. I loved it.
So we have the Mogul Moves logo here on the side. Mm-hmm. One thing that I thought would be funny, but also Cutie mentioned would be a good idea, is to pay tribute to your first email, which is the brown star.
Do you know about that?
I heard what it is a reference to.
It's my butthole. All right, you paid an artist to put my butthole on a car, Chris. That's what you did.
I guess down here, Falco, Fox, Captain Falcon. We have the Rainbow Road coming out behind the car bed.
Ooh.
Little star.
Yeah.
So as far as the art is concerned, the overall theme, the reason we put you in space, looking at the way your viewership looked, I think you are probably the most unique streamer in terms of like coming up in your own right. So part of the reason we wanted to put you in outer space, kind of put you on your own planet, is because kind of like your own world.
Yeah.
Whereas like, you know, when you start to, you know, collaborate with other streamers and people see you, those worlds kind of mix, and it's like this awesome crossover episode when your favorite streamers collab.
Yeah.
But that's why I decided, you know, one of the things I wanted to do is to try to keep you like, this is you, this is your, this is how you came up, and this is your own thing.
Yeah, that's super sick. And yeah. I think, right, it's very thoughtful.
Anyways, yes. Do you want to see it turned on?
I would love to.
Okay.
We have an outlet here, if that's...
Perfect.
It costs $280. Can you see that? You know what the biggest scam of it all is? Watch this, ready? Okay, front lights, back lights, right? Little backup lights, little front lights. Check this shoe. I bought it 1 week ago! And in 2 days, the front lights broke.
Let's see, turn on.
$200 for that.
$280.
After you, the white button on top.
Ready?
Yeah.
That's dope.
You like it?
Yeah, that's insane.
So if you take a look at the CPU cooler after it loads into Windows here in a second, it'll show you something else too. As you can see with some of the art, it is printed in different layers so that some of the RGB LED strips in the back will shine a little bit better on different layers of the art.
Oh! That's insane! Ludwig Mogul Moves! That's sick, you animated it.
So we have the chessboard illuminated in the back. Every diagonal piece should have its own little bit of RGB shining through.
Yeah, that's awesome. Can it touch? Is that bad?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. This is sick.
The cards now come out as a little bit holographic. The darker it is in the room, the more it'll shine.
Oh, we can turn, we can get a little sexy here. I can just close this.
Oh, there we go. So we actually added this little white LED strip on the side so the art's a little bit easier to see.
Oh, this thing?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I guess parts-wise really quickly, you have an RTX 3080 from EVGA.
Hooked up by Aatrox?
No.
Wow, Aatrox, really? Really? I bought his hotel for this weekend in Vegas and you couldn't have gotten, really? Shame on you. I'm switching it out with an AMD.
Well, for the processor, you have an AMD Ryzen 9 5900X.
Okay.
So 12 cores, 24 threads, way more than a streamer typically needs, but I'm sure it'll be great.
I don't know. Emulating Mario's pretty intensive.
For the RAM, you got 32 gigabytes of DDR4, clocked at 3600 megahertz, so it'll be plenty fast. Cool. If you're like a Chrome tab type of guy, you should be able to open up at least three.
Big win.
Oh, your drive. Your drive is actually pretty fast. It's a Western Digital 2 terabyte SN750, but it's a 2 terabyte drive. It should be 3500 read and write speed, which will be plenty fast for any game or multiple games that you launch on stream or multiple instances of a game.
Yeah, this is a, this, can I, it, you don't swear much, and this is, we're trying to monetize this.
You can.
Beautiful. This is the most beautiful machine I've ever seen. And the fact that I will be able to stream just on a practicality standpoint without my camera going black when I open up Photoshop is pretty amazing as well. Not to mention the art. That was super, super thoughtful art. You must know more about me than I do at this point.
For 2-3 weeks, I feel a little bit creepy because I'm doing that much research. Yeah, but
you're probably sick of me at this point. Move on to Clint Stevens, other creators. This is amazing though.
I'm sorry it took as long as it did.
Don't apologize. I think this is an insane timeline. It didn't even take that long. You DM'd me like a month or two ago about it, and pretty much all I did was sleep on stream for 300 hours in the meantime. So,
ooh, the top looks cool. Ooh, the front looks cool too.
I didn't realize it was a not flat.
Yeah, the mesh rigs are hard to print on, but they did a really good job.
Yeah, they did do well. Who's there?
So V1 Tech prints the art. Savanto designed the art. I came up with the concept, and then Micro Center supplied the parts.
Awesome. I'm still paying you.
I'm going to disable my, I'm disabling everything. I don't want to be paid ever again.
What does that mean?
I'm never accepting money.
Wait, Frody, what do you mean?
I'm disabling everything.
What happened that you had a negative experience getting paid where you don't want to get paid?
No, nothing.
Anymore?
It's just stuff like this typically is a gift, you know?
I feel that. It's just such a overwhelmingly nice gift that I, as a human, am unable to emotionally comprehend it. Thus, I have to bring in a monetary compensation because my emotions can't compensate.
Part of the reason I wanted to do this is because I really appreciate people that put out good vibes on the internet. Mm-hmm. You know, even if this is like a strictly business type thing, we focus on this from the model and the numbers. There are people, especially a couple of years ago, that take, you know, really negative routes for engagement, sure, for numbers, for all that stuff. And I've never gotten that vibe from you. When I started seeing more of your content and I got a better grasp on the type of stuff that you do, I was just like, that's a project I'd like to do.
Yeah.
So I really, if you're okay with it, I really like it to be a gift just because I appreciate what you do. Wow. So that's why I wanted this to happen.
All right. Yeah. That's really sweet. Yeah. This is amazing. I'm going to use it. I'm going to use it today. This will be my new hub. All righty.
That was a clean peel, actually.
That feels good. Ooh.
I look so handsome.
I don't know. They made me have like the sickest chin of all time.
You look very, very like, for one handsome, just, this is too much.
Yeah. 3080 though.
They got a 3080.
Which means.
We actually had to kill a guy to get that.
Yeah.
They told me off camera.
Yeah.
This is sick. Wow. Well done. Well done, team. I'm glad we could all celebrate this together with my involvement.
We all did this.
We all did this. Especially you and I.